From Southampton to Singhampton, you're listening to Georgian Bay Today on 560 CFOS.
Where it is 12:09, good Wednesday afternoon. Welcome to Georgian Bay Today. I'm Mary Paifa. You know, OSCVI here in Owen Sound is making a difference in the world. Do you know how? Well, we'll explain. Today there was a special day at the school, helping to kick off one of their big events being held next month. And we have three students from OSCVI, the Falcons here in studio, Ben Heppel, Jacqueline Parks, and Nathan Russell. Guys, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having us, Manny.
That's great. I appreciate it. Now, you had an assembly this morning. What was that about?
Today's assembly was to kick off an incredible event that we have had last year at the OSCVI and we're having again this year. And what this event is called the Inside Ride. And what we do is we gather teams from not just the school, but the community, other elementary schools, and our friends over at Georgian College. And teams of six ride a stationary bicycle, 10 minutes each, with the goal of gathering a distance and raising money for childhood cancer.
Wow. Who came up with this idea?
Well, last year we had it at our school. Our principal, Matt Pickett, and teacher Michael Harris started organizing it and getting it together. We have a unique situation at OSCVI. Two of our students, well, one former now, Cynthia Watson and late Brendan Rourke, both battled cancer tirelessly, and we thought this was an incredible event to honor both of them and their families.
Wow, and this is the second annual event, right, Jacqueline?
Yes. Last year, we had 34 teams, and this year, we plan to have much more and make it bigger and better the second time around.
Wow, that'd be great. So there's six to a bike, and you're all pedaling towards one goal in the relay to try to make it a distance. It's not necessarily a race, is it, Ben?
No, it's no race. It's every person to their own ability, but you'll find like all the teams are standing around the bike cheering their hearts out. Like, you'll see people yelling. You'll see people in costume. Last year, we had some people from Georgian College dressed as grapes, actually. They had purple balloons all over their bodies, and it was pretty hilarious to watch.
Wow, so you can really get into it. And all this is you're raising money. So how do you raise money? You collect pledges throughout the community?
Yeah, we students can go out and talk to their friends, their family, people they know. And what you're collecting money towards is an organization called Child Can that raises money to assist families who have children who are suffering from cancer. And one of the unique things about Child Can is that with other organizations, you're not always sure what percentage is going to help the family, but 100% of donations are going straight to the families and straight to assist those who are struggling with childhood cancer.
So let's talk a little bit about Child Can, because I don't think many people have heard of this group. So Child Can is a group that helps kids and their families?
Yeah, they help kids and their families pay for costs that you wouldn't necessarily think of when you think of a battle with childhood cancer, such as parking tickets. They help pay for gas. They help pay for mortgage payments. They help pay for post-secondary education. And the thing with Child Can that is unique from a lot of different organizations is they go to local families. So from the places, like if you donate from Owen Sound, the region would be like from Tobermory to, is it Meaford? Somewhere around there.
Right, so the money stays in the community. The money that you raise here locally stays in the community.
Yep.
That's great. So how do you get teams to sign up, Jacqueline?
Within our school, teams of six are asked to form, and then a captain will be appointed to go online and register a team. Other members from the community are also asked to do the same or contact the school and put in a team of six.
So anyone listening right now, if they think this is a great idea, they can contact the school and sign up six people to register and take part?
Yeah, and we're also online. You can search either OSCVI Inside Ride on Facebook to get some information regarding our Inside Ride. You can search The Inside Ride on Facebook. You can follow at The Inside Ride on Twitter. And our URL is OSCVI.theinsideride.com.
Perfect. Now, this is inside the school.
Yes, in this cold weather, we do keep it inside, and it's warm, it's intense, it's packed, there's loud music, it's an incredible event.
And we should tell people the date. It's March 28th, so that is the actual date of the event. So everyone has about a month to register. So it's as simple as going online and registering my team. If I want to get five other people with me from the radio station, just go online to oscbi.com. theinsideride.com.
Yeah, and you can call the school if you have any questions. Email the school. Search us on Facebook. And there's a lot of different options to get involved.
Ben Heppel, Jacqueline Parks, and Nathan Russell from OSCVI are our guests today, talking about the second annual Inside the Ride, taking place on March 28th. Kickoff was held this morning at the school at a special assembly, and we're glad that the students are here. Now, we lost Brendan. Unfortunately, he passed away in 2012. This event is partly to honor him. Why don't you each share something about Brendan that stands out for you guys?
Well, right from the time that I started high school, I really looked up to someone like Brendan. Brendan was a fantastic athlete. He played on the school volleyball team, like myself. And being a senior, we all really looked up to Brendan. And once it was discovered that Brendan had had cancer, his role on the OSCVI volleyball team kind of turned from on the court to off the court. And he kind of became a symbol of how hard you should work in life and his constant struggle and vigor. And we all really looked up to Brendan. And even though he wasn't on the court with us, he was there in the stands cheering us on. He was still really a part of our team.
How do you guys remember Brendan?
I first met Brendan in grade 10. We had a glee club at our school, and he was on the guitar. He was unreal at it. Played Don't Stop Believing. He could play all the notes perfectly first try. We started hanging out. Like, I was hanging out with his friends and stuff, and you'd find he never really brought it up. Like, he would always still be, like, living like everything was exactly the same. He was a hilarious guy, great sense of humor, and he was really just someone you wanted to be around and wanted to be around for a long time.
I didn't know Brendan personally, but I knew of him. And when he got sick, he became a symbol for the school of courage and determination. And everyone started to look up to him, even the people who didn't know him personally.
And you mentioned this event, too, helps Cynthia?
Yeah, we had a student who graduated from our school last year named Cynthia Watson. And Cynthia as well had battled cancer for a few years, and she's very involved last year. I'm sure she'll be involved again this year. And yeah, it's also an honor of her and her family.
Great to see her on March 28th. And again, if you have any questions or would like to sign up, you can call the school as well if you have any questions that way at 376-2010. You're on Facebook. It's called OSCVI Inside the Ride, and the website is OSCVI.theinsideride.com. Ben Apple, Jacqueline Parks, Nathan Russell, thank you very much for all being here and sharing.
Thank you for having us, Manny.
And we wish you all the best. Remember, you've got a month to sign up for the event. Circle March 28th on your calendar. Still coming up in the show, we'll find out how you can nominate someone to be the Volunteer of the Year and the Senior of the Year in the city of Owen Sound. But we'll take a look at your weather forecast and business news next on Georgian Bay Today on 560 CFOS.